So I'm on my way to Onku Recording Studios today. It's the 13th of January 2014. About to record a song called United as One. So here I am at Onku Studios. Angie's on the case. And I've got Marvin here on the boards. Maestro, he's the guy who makes the magic happen. I'm here with Junjun.
Hello, hello.
And he's a drummer for today. He's going to be the backbone. He is the rock upon which I build my rock.
Well, it began several years back when a huge typhoon hit the Philippines, Ondoy, and it hit us so bad, including an orphanage that I was trying to help. What happened was I sent out this panic email to everybody, and among those who responded was MiG Ayesa. And he responded as an artist would, which was immediately to be creative about it and come up with a song that people could use, could view, and through which they could send their donations to either the orphanage or to the Red Cross.
You know, MiG is a good friend of mine, and I always believed in his craft, and his songwriting is superb. So when he sent me an email, without batting an eyelash, I said, yes, I'll help you out.
And that was how the whole thing started. It was just a series of back and forth emails between MiG and me. I was floored that he wanted to do that and how quickly he did it. I mean, because he was in the States and I was here, we were like 12 hours apart, time zone wise. I go to sleep, I wake up, and there's the song.
And through the years, I realized that the Philippines was actually experiencing and suffering all these typhoons and floods, that this song could be used again and again as a kind of call to arms, I suppose.
First time I heard it, it blew me away. And normally songs like, that was a year ago, if I'm not mistaken, a year ago or something. And, you know, after listening to it again here, I still get the same goosebumps.
And then now, here comes Hayan or Yolanda, and the destruction is even worse. And the fact that recovery is going to take so long, wow, what a perfect time for that song to come back. And I thought it was brilliant when MiG said he was going to bring that song to the studio, because the first copy was just something he whipped up on his laptop at home.
You see all the devastation, the death and the carnage at CNN pumped 24/7, but it was also quite essential at the time to show that the Philippines was really suffering. The sad thing is about all this is that people thought that the Philippines was completely destroyed. People were canceling their trip to Boracay, people were canceling their trip to north-south regions. What we need to do to fill it up is to entice people back to the Philippines. That became our mission, to show the beauty of the Philippines, to show that the resilience of the Philippines, to show that these people are there and they're welcoming, they're wanting you to come and visit this incredible country.
So I believe in the song, I really love it.
Galing!
Take one, ah.
I love it, I just heard it now. I love what it's become.
If I had more than 10 thumbs, I'd give it more than 10.
Hopefully in season 2 of Fill It Up, we can go back to Tacloban and go to Visayan and film there and show you how beautiful those regions are.
And I really pray that it'll hit people so that they won't assume that, okay, the worst is over, it's done. It isn't. The real work is just beginning. This is the hardest part of all, to rebuild. So that's why I'm sending it all the good vibes in the world. Boom!